In 1972, the Nation of Israel was less than 30 years old, but its Olympic movement was thriving with athletes and coaches who had immigrated from all over the world.
Andre Spitzer is the fencing coach. For him, participating in the Olympics crowns the greatest time of his life. A year earlier, Andre got married. His wife, Anki, gave birth to their first child just 5 weeks ago.
We were a young couple, very much in love, and we just had a beautiful baby daughter was born, so what could go wrong? Nothing.
Andre Spitzer, born in Romania, was the head of Israel's fencing program. He met his wife Anki in Holland, and together they had moved to Israel.
People told me you will never feel at home there because it's way out in the boondocks, you know, there's nothing there. And that was exactly what was so nice, because they built an academy for fencing on the Lebanese border, and that's where we lived. And I must say that even though it was not the regular life, because it was only us and the students, I remember that year as the most beautiful year of my life.
For the Israelis, a return to Germany less than 30 years after the Holocaust was an exercise in courage and determination. The Munich Stadium was built less than 20 miles from Dachau, and the nearness of these ghosts haunted this delegation. Several members of the team had either lost their families in Nazi camps or were themselves survivors.
Among them, Israeli fencing coach Andre Spitzer.
We had the time of our lives. You know, it was also my first Olympics, but because I was there with Andre, and every day we went to competitions, we walked around the village, we went to see movies, there was jam sessions with music, we met all kinds of international athletes. I mean, this was really, in my opinion, the right concept of the games.
Anki Spitzer lived outside the Olympic compound, but even without a pass, entering the grounds was easy.
Andre had a pass, but I didn't. So what did we do? I figured that according to the German concept, the exit is only for going out and not for going in. So I came in every day through the exit, you know, and nobody questioned me. We said, guten Tag, wie geht's, yeah? And then we went to his room and I slept there.
On September the 3rd, day 8 of the competition, Andre Spitzer had a day off. He and his wife traveled to Holland, where their 2-month-old daughter was being treated in a hospital. Andre returned to Munich that evening.
The train was standing in the station. We both opened the doors and he jumped in and I started to run next to the train. And he opened the window and he said, I'm going to call you the minute I get to Munich. At midnight, he called me from Munich and he says, Anki, I'm back into the Olympic Village. I'm going to sleep in my bed, almost for the first time there, you know. I said, and is everybody there? And he said, no, nobody is here. I heard that they went to the theater to see Fiddler on the Roof, and I'll wait for them to see them. So he's talking, he says, another 50 pfennig, we have to talk. So he says, I love you, I love you. I said, I love you too. And he said, I'm angry that I couldn't stay another day.
They had this little, for however long it lasted, this glimpse of heaven, of when everything was brotherhood, could be, all the hatreds could be put aside.
I will never forget Andre at the Olympic Games in Munich. When we were walking around and suddenly he saw the Lebanese team. And he said to me, here, the Lebanese are here. I'm going to ask them how their competition went. And I said, are you crazy? You know, they're from Lebanon. We are at war with Lebanon. And he said to me, Anki, this is exactly what the Olympics are all about. There is no border here. This is not Lebanon and Israel. We are all athletes. We're all fencers. So I'm going over. And I was amazed. I was looking at it from a distance. And I will never forget Andre. When he turned around, when he finished shaking hands and everything, he turned around and he had this huge smile on his face. And he walked towards me and he said, you see, This is what the Olympics are all about.
This story is not about 11 Israelis that were murdered. It's about 11 athletes who came in hope for friendship and fair play and in the name of sport and came back in coffins. That's not the Olympic idea. That's not the Olympic dream. And it should never happen again.